我们刚刚所看到的是战争与复仇的故事，这一段我们要为大家所说的是爱的故事。什么是爱的故事呢？上礼拜我们特别为大家报道台湾的邦交国在非洲的史瓦济兰，它几乎将近40%到50%的都是艾滋病的患者。当地的医疗疾病到什么程度呢？有一张非常经典的照片，他们来看台北医学大学所派出的医生来看诊的时候，是第一个有眼睛的人，然后后面的人就是一根棍子，一根棍子后面再带一个人，这个人后面再一根棍子再带一个人。为什么？因为后面的人他们全部都因为感染一个特别的细菌，眼睛全部都瞎掉了。他们要来找台北医学院一个远自他们所不知道的地方台湾来的医生，给他们人生第一次的医疗。在上礼拜我们报道这个故事引起很多观众的回响。事实上台北医学院不只是派了他们的医生团到这个地方进行义诊，他甚至让还在读医学院的学生们花30天的时间来体验作为一个医生的职责。爱是他们到非洲踏上去的时候在踩在土地上最重要的力量。
30天你能完成什么？完成一个探险，一个瘦身疗程，或是一个买房计划。而有一群年轻的孩子30天完成了一个奉献生命分享爱的旅程。生命的旅程不都是吃喝玩乐的？这群20岁不到的年轻孩子们从史瓦济兰首都往北走，一路泥泞，好几次车轮爆胎，想探望的是他们史瓦济兰的山地郊区孤儿院。才一开门呢，还在上课的小毛头们全挤向门口探头探脑，课程被迫中断。
时间还没到，时间还没到。
有哥哥姐姐们来是大事，因为这里的孩子们习惯了一个人，习惯了起床一个人坐在床上没有人哄，习惯了鼻涕挂脸上没有阿公阿妈们急着擦掉，自己推小车，自己抱洋娃娃，午餐每人一块南瓜加上蔬菜和饭，也是自己拿着餐盘放小腿上抓着自己吃。生命的旋律仿佛是无伴奏乐曲，孩子们于是防卫性的先看着你，然后才露出笑容。太成熟，你忘记他们其实只是2-3岁的孩子。最残忍的事实是，史瓦济兰成为全球艾滋盛行率最高的国家，这个孤儿院里50%的孩子艾滋带源，许多孩子和哥哥姐姐一块成了孤儿，因为爸爸妈妈都死于艾滋。
One time there was this child, it was a young girl, she was 4 years old. The child lived with the mother, but the mother had this AIDS, so the mother was sick, and the mother dies in front of the child, and they are together in the house, in the room. At night, they heard the child crying, and then they know the neighbors. They said, "Why is this child crying and crying?" When they went there to check, they found that the mother is dead, and this child is crying and looking at the mother dying. So it affects the child. The child is not right in the brain, and this child has been raped by people because this child keeps going asking for food, and she gets raped. Why? Sometimes the child gets raped and the person has AIDS. The child has AIDS now also.
I-N-G-O-N, feeling the world is there. 在残破、强风不断灌注的铁皮屋里，来自台湾的台北一大志工团打着哆嗦，用爱陪伴着很难打开心房的孩子们。有个孩子怯生生地问我：“星期天我还能陪他吗？”我们说不出话，只能更紧地抱住他。不只是世纪传染疾病，艾滋、AIDS 背后的歧视，孤儿平均寿命大降，更是贫穷和社会问题的根源。我们在南非北医大的台湾医疗团找到了一位愿意勇敢现身的艾滋罹患者，但我们的访谈必须常常中断，因为一旁有人靠近时，他就害怕的不愿意多讲。
When I was pregnant, I discovered a transmitted disease. I was shocked. Sex. They have sex too much, and they have sex with so many different lovers. Boys, most especially, they change ladies like pairs of socks.
Whereas in Southern Africa, when you're unhappy with the one partner, you start having another one. And that's an overlap.At the same time, and it's those overlaps that cause the spread to go so quickly. It's not the disaster, visible disaster like a tsunami or an earthquake happens, and then 6 months later you can sort of get yourself out. This takes you down for 20 years. Yeah, it takes you down. It takes your development progress back 20 years. It's a long way. We call it a long wave disaster. It's also a silent disaster.
因为看不见，宁静的艾滋病毒才恐怖。就在我们前往非洲，地球另一端的台湾也爆发艾滋危机。在联合国警告，从现在起，若施瓦季兰不对艾滋展开预防和治疗，到2020年，施瓦季兰成人可能将全死于艾滋。专家也直指，台湾感染艾滋的人数恐怕不止疾病管制局上的18000人。在长期压抑和网络一夜情泛滥之下，实际可能数十倍。非洲的艾滋风暴需要唤醒人类对艾滋孤儿的爱，更得唤醒台湾对艾滋的防治。
Do you think that one day the Swaziland could get away from the fear of HIV?
Not unless we get the treatment for HIV, but as long as we don't have.Treatment for HIV. HIV will not be finished in Swaziland.
But oh, precious name, for his name's sake, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they can't fight.